Well, we're here at the City Museum. I mean, where else could we possibly be? But we're here to talk about putting things together, finding the right pieces and the right places where they fit to create something bigger and better. Now, you'd think here that just about anything, everything, would have its place here as long as it was really, really big. And yet on the inside, there's something going on that, well, if I were doing it, I'd need strong light and my reading glasses.
This building was once occupied by the International Shoe Company. Now it's home to the City Museum, a place where children and adults can crawl through trees and slide through pipes. But if climbing through ceilings isn't your cup of tea, then trust me, the 18,000 square feet of mosaics will fascinate you.
This is Sharon Von Senden, and it's her hands that have laid nearly 5 million pieces of tile, mirror, and glass throughout the City Museum, turning cold concrete into works of art. Sharon gave me a personal tour of the mosaic world that she's created, and I had some pretty serious questions to ask her.
So Sharon, how did you get involved in all this? How did you start becoming a mosaic-er? What do you call yourself?
I think they're probably called a mosaicist.
Mosaicist, okay.
Once I got up to speed, we got down to business. It's hard to believe by looking at this place, but Sharon hasn't been a mosaicist all that long. As she puts it, she spent most of her life wandering around this earth trying to find the one thing she was meant to do.
I worked in a nursing home, I joined the army, I worked in a shrimp factory, I worked in a bohemian coffee house, and found out that maybe there was something that I was really good at after all these years.
One day Sharon began doing some tile work for that bohemian coffee house, something she had never done before. And in 1997, her work at the cafe caught the eye of the owners of the City Museum, and they hired her to mosaic 4 columns.
Well, did you have any idea that it was going to be to mosaic the entire space, or just, I'll do a column here and there and call it a day?
No. When I came, I was going to work for 8 weeks.
So did you have all this mapped out when you first started? Do you have any idea what you were doing? Fly by the seat of your pants?
The first thing that I ever did at the museum was this column.
Uh-huh.
He said I could do anything I wanted. And I thought, well, you know, this is an aquarium.
Right.
So let's put some fish up there.
But 8 weeks and 4 columns later, Sharon was still at the museum tiling away.
Come up with what materials you're going to use. Where do you get them? Do you have a supplier? Do you randomly acquire different materials?
These oyster shells were brought up from Louisiana in the back of a pickup truck. My son happened to be going down to Louisiana at that time, and I teasingly said, if you see any dead oysters along the way, would you please bring your shells back to me? So he brought a pickup truck full of oyster shells. And the average person would not think that these oyster shells that laid on a beach or at the bottom of the ocean and were washed ashore would one day be on a column in the City Museum.
Your canvas here is tall, it's low, it's not the easiest place to work. To say that you painstakingly have mosaic, this whole area, is an understatement. What does that do physically?
It's very hard. It's very hard. I'm not as young as once I was. I wish I had been a little more clever to know that I was good at this before I found it out.
Well, you had to wander the earth a while before you figured out what you were going to do.
But despite not being as young as once she was, Sharon manages to get the job done. After all, there are always a few people around to distract her from those aches and pains.
Obviously, it's very loud in here.
Very loud.
And you work with, you know, hundreds of kids running around all the time.
Sometimes thousands. Thousands, too. I've worked here when there were 3,500 people in here.
That would drive me nuts. How do you do that?
My most important tool is my Sony CD player. And as long as Celine Dion and Elton John and Joan Baez sing to me, I'm a happy woman.
Just fade away. Don't you know?